Welcome to this week's edition of the WBUC Friday Show. I'm Kiera Allen.
And I'm Trenton Davis. At Hoover High School, many students have different talents. One student dedicates himself to his talent of dancing. Reporter Dylan Mwangi and Jordan Polino have the story.
Students here at Hoover with talent. Those talents include music, art, singing, and dance. But who's to say that these students are truly dedicated to what they do? Jordan Brown, also known as Click, has been dedicated to his art of dance since freshman year.
I've been dancing for 3 years and 2 months, exactly.
His dance style is known as animation.
Animation, in my definition, is portraying an animated character or a non-human-like figure.
Watching other animation dancers is what inspired Jordan to dance.
My inspirations are Blueprint from Dragon House, Nonstop from Dragon House, Mind Trick, he lives over in London. What got me into dancing is watching Dragon House videos and trying to do the same.
Jordan has won many accolades because of his talent and dedication to dance.
Last year, he won a House of Battles competition hosted here in Birmingham. He won the talent show 10th and 11th grade year. He even won a status silver contest, which he received prizes from California.
Despite perfecting dance, Jordan is still able to balance his schoolwork.
School always comes first, of course, but I try to do my homework before I practice, projects before I practice, and study for tests before I practice.
So what's the next step for Jordan Brown? He plans on taking his talents to college while still aspiring to pursue a career and become famous.
Keep dancing, try to make it, be famous. Professional dancer.
With hard work and dedication, one can prevail in a talent that they love. Reporting from WBUC News, I'm...
Course registration is coming up, and WBUC's Whitney Thomas and Cassidy Bradley have a story on one of Hoover High School's newest academies.
Deciding what classes you want to take next year, one class that you don't want to forget about is Hoover High School's Education Academy. The Education Academy is a program that teaches Hoover students about teaching and other careers working with children.
WBUC talked with Education Academy director and teacher Jennifer Paradise, who says that the Education Academy is a great opportunity for Hoover students.
The Education Academy is a dynamic learning experience for students who have a passion to aspire one day to be teachers, counselors, coaches, child psychologists.
Ms. Paradise says that the Education Academy consists of four different courses over the 4 years of high school.
You start with education and training, which embeds career preparedness components in it. So we start learning about the field of teaching and counseling and coaching. Then you move into teaching one, teaching two, and then finally you are a completer with the education and training internship, which is the fourth year program.
For students worried about their homework load, Ms. Paradise says that the Education Academy classes do not assign a lot of homework.
In my academy, we really do a lot of hands-on work within the classroom, so there is minimal homework because I am aware of all the extraneous variables that students have in their daily schedule.
WBUC talked with Education Academy student Emily Emerson. She says that her favorite part of the Education Academy is job shadowing.
You actually get real-life experience doing what you love and interacting with the kids and seeing what teachers do every day.
For students interested in teaching and other careers working with children, Ms. Paradise invites you to join the Education Academy for a great learning experience.
If you really have a passion to want to work with students and help children, then we would love for you to join the Education Academy, so come be a learner today and a leader tomorrow.
Reporting for WBUC News.
There are many great teachers at Hoover High School, but this teacher stands out among others. WBUC's Jocelyn Freeman has the story.
Jordan football coach Michael Brown has moved from Mississippi to California, back to Mississippi, then to Alabama, and says that moving is just a part of life, and he informs his children of that.
People that you can be a part of their life, they can be a part of yours. Maybe you can be a good influence on them, and you can be blessed at the same time. So that's kind of part of it.
Brown says that it's been a tough time being away from his family, but he also states that he and his family just have to learn how to figure it out. He is a very involved dad, and says that he does everything possible to still be involved in his children's lives, even though he lives in a different state 5 days out of the week.
We've just kind of had to adapt and overcome that. I'm very hands-on dad. I'm very into what my kids are doing at school, and their lives, you know. So every night we're Skyping and talking about how school went during the day, and you know, my daughter or son may have an issue, and we just resolve it. And if I'm not home that night, and then the next night when I am, we just, you know, see if it's taken care of. And you know, I'm still dad.
Brian has taught at a variety of different schools, but says that Hoover is just a little bit of them all mixed together.
You know, I've taught in Mississippi, I've taught in North Alabama, some great schools, large schools, small schools. I've kind of been there, done that. But Hoover is just for the diversity of people, not just individuals that are from this area. Hoover's kind of a, you know, it seems kind of like a melting pot of individuals and personalities. And it's a comparison. It's like where I've been all rolled into one on a bigger level, you know. But the expectations are higher here because it's a high level school that's been champions in the classroom and on the field. So that's, I mean, it is what it is. It speaks for itself. Everybody knows who Hoover is.
He's a very committed teacher and father. He drives all the way from Mississippi on Mondays to be able to teach his students, and then drives back to Mississippi to be able to be with his kids. Reporting from WBEC, I'm...
Ms. Grant hosted Team Up for St. Jude Week this past week, March 16th through 20th. There were activities in the courtyard during all 4th and 5th luncheon advisory periods, such as balloon dart games, trivia crack, minute to win it games, pie day, and wheelchair races. The all-week activities were bouncy houses, inflatable slides, the piggy bank challenge and advisory, and all proceeds went to St. Jude Research Hospital in Memphis, Tennessee.
This week, Teens Need Teens hosts HHS Clean Break Week to promote abstinence from drugs, alcohol, and tobacco. WBUC's Whitney Thomas and my co-anchor, Kiara Allen, have the story.
High school's Teens Need Teens are hosting HHS Clean Break Week. HHS Clean Break Week is designed to raise awareness about the dangers of drugs, alcohol, and tobacco, and promote abstinence of these harmful substances during spring break. On Thursday, TNT hosted a spring break party in the courtyard where you can play different games and hang out with your friends. TNT coordinator Mr. Butler hopes that HHS Clean Break will help students make good decisions.
Kind of help our students in high school, which we know are the ones dealing with this the most, to kind of be able to make positive choices in their lives.
Mr. Butler thinks one of the major issues for students during spring break is binge drinking.
I mean, they don't have anywhere to be the next day. They're with a lot of friends that are kind of in a similar mindset of let's just go out and party. So I think it's a big deal for people that are in high school and accomplishing big things to show what a good example is, and to realize that you don't have to drink alcohol to have fun, and there are other ways to have fun that aren't so self-destructive.
Mr. Butler believes that it is important to spread the message of abstinence because many students are misinformed about the normality of drinking.
Well, a lot of kids in high school just assume that everybody's doing the things that they're doing and think that it's like 80% of the population, but I think there's still is a large majority of people that don't drink or do drugs.
For Hoover High School's HHS Clean Break, students will hopefully learn more about the importance of abstinence and that there are many other ways to have fun and be safe this spring break. Reporting for WBEC News, I'm Whitney Thomas.
In sports news, outdoor track will compete in the Sugar Bowl Classic in New Orleans, Louisiana, and the freshman baseball team will host Festavia at 4 p.m. and 6 p.m.
As far as weather this weekend goes, it's going to be chilly. Tonight, there is a high of 56 and a low of 36. Tomorrow, there will be a high of 55 and a low of 32.
Today, we're going to leave you with a music video produced by Wes Maha, Trenton Davis, and Chris Brady.
Be sure to join us again next time. I'm Trenton Davis.
And I'm Kiara Allen. From the entire WBUC news staff, have a great spring break.
And go Bucks! Bucks.
All right, class. Music 101. Our lesson today is going to be, I need everyone to pay attention to what I got going on up here, because music's very hard, and no one seems to, Gigi, you're not paying any attention. Do you think you can teach this class any better than I can?
No, I think you got it.
No, I think you need to come on up here, show the class what you can do.
Come on up and show me. These people want to listen to you. Come teach this class.
Okay. I can't wait for school to be out again.
two, let's go do us three, four. Together we score 1, 5, 6. The number one chicks in 7, 8. Don't be late in 9, 10. School's out again. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Seven, six, five, four.